One of the things I was most disappointed of not doing while I was in Turkey was being more in the balcony, just chilling with my laptop or something.
Right. It's something I have to think about as well when it becomes warm weather, whether or not you should be in, like, I should go in my yard and just chill there.
Yeah.
Because I could do that, but the only thing I don't like is that my screen, that the sunlight blocks my screen. Then again, there's no sun.
Oh, should try it out and see how well it goes. You could probably just sit there, watch some anime or something. Well, it's nice and sunny and warm. Well, I have a
Probably,
cola and
honestly,
tea.
I'll probably have like family over when it gets warm. Then we can all chill in the sun.
I don't know if you. Nah, you don't need to have like a mini fridge. People just go back inside to go to the fridge.
Right, what the fuck is? Honestly, if I have all the extra mini fridge it did before this room, I actually need to buy a big fridge at some point. Then I'll have a mini fridge for this room. Because I
You
really
use
want.
them, say, mini fridge just there instead.
Yeah, I could have a mini fridge outside, technically. Sure, I could do that, but I'm not sure. Maybe I should buy multiple mini fridges. Everywhere
Oh,
is a fridge. Emergency cola.
no. It's like you simply just move out the cola just to make sure that wherever it is, it's fucking cold.
We've brought a letter to this girl. Like, she apparently stopped working at the bakery to work for her dad because. Even though her dad was a dick, he lost, you know, she was trying to pay for the medical bills and shit like that. Then we have this guy who's friends with her dad when we threw the message, like the letter back to him. A letter to him, and it's like, he's the doctor of her dad. And he basically tells us that, you know, the money is not the problem. Her father's leg is just not something he could treat.
Oh. How sad.
If only we had magic to heal the leg. I could not heal his leg. It's impossible. I'm a fucking doctor, not a magician. If only I had magic users in our party, Anders, then we could probably heal the leg.
If only. Oh wait, I know. Eric is a magician. He can heal him.
But at the time, I could not help her. The treatment required her puppy cost far more than she. I believe that is why she abandoned the Korea's bakery. She wanted to earn more money, that's so she could save up. Fortunately, it is impossible for me to treat her father's injury. Please, take this letter, Akia. It's very important. More important to see. Alright, so basically tell her and maybe hopefully she goes back to work on the bakery. Besides that. Man, I got spoiled on 14.
What did you do?
I just went to the comments of like the death scene, and then someone was like, "Hey, blah blah blah." I'm like, "Oh."
Oh no. To be honest, if I fucking seen it right, like the fucking thumbnail for the 5.5 patch says a lot, does it not?
Yeah, honestly, I went to the wiki page for character, and there's no death state, so I'm like, "Oh." And then I read what happened, and I'm like, wow, we got bamboozled.
I know, right?
Really? Like, honestly, though, it's a plot twist that actually makes sense compared to Eranger. Yeah, Eranger was evil all along. Yeah, fuck you. It was
Yeah, I
bullshit.
know. It's like that does feel bullshit. I wonder what the fuck is up with that. Yeah, honestly, let's avoid more comment section before we and trailers before we do something wrong. Man, I can't believe.
It's like, I can't believe.
Yeah, you wanna know though? I can't believe fucking Robodon just fucking sliced the man in half.
It was awesome.
Yeah, it's like, damn, just the
Wonder what he
fucking.
think. Wonder what he thinks when like the lava flow comes to him and goes like, "So, you know, what if I told you that I actually helped you out without you knowing? What? What if I told you that Sultana is still alive? What?"
What are you talking about? The fucking midget that tried to poison her, or do you mean the midget that like with the white cap?
The wizard with the white cap. Yeah, he knew of his plan, so he swapped the fucking poison with sleeping with the sleeping with the sleeping
That didn't look
pot.
very convincing, though, you fucking dick.
It
She
looked
was
way too
fucking.
convincing. It
It
looked too
looked like she was.
convincing. Well, to be
Yeah, she
fair, did she actually check her body?
Well, to be fair, the fucking dick with rich guy was all about like trying to poison her. That is like he walks up, he like look at the wine. I'm like, yeah, this wine is poisonous. How do you fucking know?
How do you know?
Then the fucking girl is like fucking suffocating. Are you sure it was not poison? Fucking sleeping meds were those.
Yeah, that's a very strong sleeping potion. You would sleep for a week.
It's like fucking Jesus fucking Christ. Alright, man. Guys, we got one big fucking reveal out of the way.
I'm sorry, man. It's just like someone in the trailer goes like, well, this is not actually. Someone in the comments basically is like, yeah, this is not actually dead. I'm like, wait, what?
Yeah, to be fair, if I look at the fucking, maybe I should have done better, but that, who cares?
I guess I shouldn't have been too surprised. Like, who would kill the lolly?
Yeah, who would kill her?
What, like, it has to be some insane writer, like some evil writer, you know?
Yeah. Well, in case we have some big fighting left ahead of us in that fucking game.
Well, we're practically done with Ghost of the Veil. It's just side quests now, I believe. I don't actually know what I'm doing here. Yeah, I'm killing that guy. Then we're gonna go back. We got the floral coral. Florale corale. And with the florale corale, we will give it back to this man. So he can please his really, really kind of bitchy wife, honestly.
Yeah.
I don't have a good impression of her, you know? She's kind of like, Jesus Christ.
It's all her whole behavior, whole look and everything. It's like she looked... Yeah, fuck her.
Like, honestly, it's not gonna... This relationship is not gonna be happy at all. Just say... The moment she has kids, she's gonna divorce and make you pay half.
It's like, unless you do things right? Like, for example...
Take half your shit and then leave with the kids. You never see your kids too, by the way. All that. Especially in such a thing. I think that thing is especially happening in America a lot. What
yeah. Think?
Yeah. Like, Jesus Christ.
I don't know what part, but yeah, there's some places in the world that are really fucking bad with their divorces.
Mm-hmm.
It's like one of the classic ones that as long as she cannot prove that she is that the mother or father is.
We got the helicopter.
Wait, wasn't that was the multi-targeting move, right?
Yes, it was. Now we can. Yeah, it's not the dick spin move, unfortunately. Helicopter.
Well, it's still useful. It sadly enough, it just focuses on groups, probably. Yeah.
Like these knights over here. Oh no, the pirates. My bad. So these are. Clearly pirates, Ennis. Don't they look like pirates to you, Ennis?
Yes. I watched One Piece D&D. This is indeed a pirate.
Okay, I really do have to say, I really love this pun, Robin Hood. That's actually a pretty genius one. I cannot say, I'll comment them for that one. Basically, use Bang Veronica. Jesse, why didn't you just use helicopter?
Because you forgot the hero as a dick.
A big dick.
Helicopter.
Helicopter.
Good old noble. Back when YouTube didn't constantly get down his fucking throat.
Right. You know, anime fans are the most oppressed group.
Change my mind.
Together with lolicons.
Change my mind. Oh, with that I mean I'm just bitchy bad. It's like just change my mind. That they're not.
They practically are, come on.
Why? Why does he have such a name?
What? Kami Samaya. I don't know. Maybe his parents looked at his hair and went like, ah, oh, Kami! Kami Samaya! But Kami is okay. Also Kami also means hair. Kami Soma.
And the helicopter was certainly an awesome move, Jess.
Yeah, we've been really nice right about now, right?
So strong, so powerful, much wows.
Yeah, it'd be cool if I were to actually use. By the way, boss battles usually don't have items to steal. I noticed that. No!
Yep, game over. This is the end.
Can't move on anymore. Good thing we have, don't have that Vergonian rule on. Oh yeah, right. Seeing how it's like a 50% chance to bring someone back to life, so yeah, we're gonna have a bit of fun with that one.
No matter what game I play, I hate that.
Like when the main character dies and then the game over.
No, that's certainly one thing I absolutely hate, but I was talking about the revive spell missing. Not many games do that, but the one game that does is fucking Final Fantasy II.
Final Fantasy II has a lot of problems, though. Have you seen the review?
Yes, I did. It's like, oh, you want your fucking heal spell to work? Like, 100% of the time, better bring it to level fucking 16.
Yeah.
You want your Ensuna spell to work 100%, better bring it to level fucking 16.
Calm down, Robin Hood! Stop quitting so much!
And like, what are you trying to do?
Don't you like grinding every single individual fucking stat in existence?
So, how much is FTS? What the fuck are you doing anyway? Why aren't you attacking him?
I want to revive King! Finally! Alright, let's kill him.
What a waste of fucking time.
Shut up. I need all my party members to be alive, dammit. It's for morale. No one gets left behind.
It's like, I've learned the rule that whenever you play Final Fantasy II, at least you do it on GBA or PSP, right?
Mm-hmm.
Always, what's it called? Always use the revive and Ensuna spell after the fight.
Does level up when you do it?
And not level up, it's a 100% guaranteed chance that it works, right?
Yeah.
Outside of battle. Yeah, you know, then That doesn't change the fact that you might just get fucked over by one enemy encounter that just happened to have Petrify or Doom.
I love Final Fantasy too, I don't.
It's like, legit, fucking make sure you have your shields equipped, people, because those are going to be your lifesavers.
What do you mean that you didn't do real swords?
Oh, dual wielding swords is good though. Not amazing, but good though. It makes the weapon grow stronger and makes the strength grow stronger. You know?
Hmm.
It's just not.
We just don't play Final Fantasy II and play a better game like Skyrim.
No, why not? I think you came up with a genius idea there, Jess. You know what? I have Skyrim on my PS4.
I don't think I have Skyrim yet.
Until they decide to fucking, you know, turn off the PS4, the PSN servers, and then kill off the PS4's fucking batteries. Can't wait for fucking jailbreaks and piracy.
Man, remember talking about bullet sponges in Halo 2? Mm-hmm. I think Crysis 2 and 3 are a little bit worse with that when it comes to like the alien enemies, like. I shot, like, in Quest 3, I just met, like, these stalker enemies, the aliens. And I shot one with, like, fucking 3 or 4 shotgun blasts, and they're still fucking alive.
Jesus, fuck. Didn't fucking expect that there for fucking Crisis.
Oh, no, that happens, especially with the aliens. And aliens in the second game, too, can, like, take a few shotgun shells as well. But taking 2 shotgun shells, I guess, is fine. It's just when it's like it's 4-4, it's like, what the fuck, man? How many fucking shotgun shells do you think I have?
All of them.
I mean, I guess the point isn't to fight all of them anyway. The point is to run away. Get the fuck out of here.
Destroy the spaceships. And then wonder, why do we bother saving our friends? Because the movie never told us why we have to save our friends.
I there are friends in us, but they shouldn't be safe.
I need to hear a reason for it. Listen, Jess, I'm intellectual. I'm intellectual person. Critic thing.
But I'm pretty sure them being our friends would be reason to save them, though.
No, that's stupid. That's just silly.
I don't even know what you're referencing.
Just watch Goodell. Apparently, some legit person was like critiquing a fucking movie or Alien, right?
Mm-hmm.
And he came with this legitimate argument of, so why is Ridley trying to save her friends? The movie never tells us the reason for why. So why bother?
Some people, man.
What can you say? They're intellectual. Far higher IQ than we will ever be. They're probably classified.
Anyway, you should not be his friend, because clearly he wouldn't save you if he needed to.
Exactly. He probably watches Rick and Morty and understands everything of it.
Must be. He probably watched Hunter x Hunter, Chimera Antark, and like understand, like sees how deep philosophical it is, and how
human
the generator makes everything better. Human bad.
The most intellectual statement that you can ever think of.
Nukes bad. Nukes did bad. Guys, people made nukes. People bad. A few humans made nukes, so all humans are just as bad as a hive mind of creatures that fucking kill and eat people for fun.
Obviously. Ooh.
Don't worry, guys. I'm not gonna kill all humanity. I'm only gonna kill 99% of them and keep the rest as slaves. Ah, character development.
It's a food farm.
Character development.
Yeah. And then somehow he falls. I guess he falls in love with this one woman. Who cares, really?
I don't even know how old she is. Nobody there would be complaining that he's like doing it with a lolly, but okay.
Yeah.
I guess if it's for intellectual reasons. If the lolly is ugly, it's okay.
No, yes, actually, it's the other way around.
Hmm?
She's a child predator because Beren was born like a year ago.
You're right. I can't fucking believe it.
He's just born. Like, what? It's not a year. It's not a year, obviously. It's like fucking 6 months or something since he came
onto
Earth.
Holy shit, I can't believe it, man.
So if we're gonna apply human standards, there you fucking go.
Yeah, no, I wouldn't, but I'm pretty sure the Hunter x Hunter fans are also the same people that are normally complain about that kind of shit, so fuck you.
They're probably the same people that don't care about what Hisoka does with his fucking dick whenever he looks at Gon.
At the moment there's like an anime with like a lolly in it, and it's like, oh my fucking god.
Where are her organs?
Now that's when it's a big titty anime go, where are her organs? Anyway, welcome to Zwaardrust. Is this my country? No, it can't be. It's not flat enough. With Jespin is Koons have this one. Dat weer dan. It's kind of a miracle we managed to get away. Problem is, it's only to... Yeah, okay, yes. So yeah, we're in Zwaardrust now. Ah, fuck him, we can't leave him. As you can see, there's a lot of, like, farm fields and stuff, and it's like a bit fill. But the thing is, the Zwaardrust is kind of like a destroyed nation long time ago. So, you know, we're not going to see like a nation state. Can't believe it, Ennis. Our country got destroyed.
Yeah. Probably, I wonder why. Is it because of how heavily the EU is forcing everybody to go over the green energy?
No, it was that... The monsters came for the tulip fields. They were jealous.
Of course. How dare you give your tulips? How dare you buy your tulips from the fucking Turks? It's our tulips, dammit!
No, Ennis, the Turks clearly buy it from us.
Honestly, I don't care. It's funny, it's like, I think both fucking nations have the tulips as their own as their symbols. In some degree. I'm not joking, right?
Guess so. It's just that we are apparently known for the tulips. Overseas. Ah ja, that's Netherlands is the place with all the tulips, right?
Yes, yes, of course, obviously. Not because of the wheat. But I'm happy to say yes before that, because we know.
Oh no, the wheat is the most important part. It's just, you know, everyone talks about that one.
That's why most of our tourists come here for.
It's the wheat.
It's like, my god, never forget it. It's the fucking story of my manager, like, fucking bringing his family over, or at least their family coming over, right? And they're like, they're driving by while he was like on the streets, and he's like, hey guys, what are you doing? And it's like looking at his grand, at his father, who's like completely high off his ass, the back of the car seat. It's like, what happened to him? Oh, you know, the usual stuff.
You know, he was high.
I mean, I swear, man, it's like some of these tourists.
My God, man, those tourists—they are very touristy.
It's like they either come here to become high or they become drunk and think they're fucking the big bad.
Big beat. Alright, time to use this point. Gonna get mending up a bit for, because why the fuck not?
It's useful.
Right? Do more healing shit. It's awesome. There's no need to worry though, you've got me on your side. I don't give up easily. I just fucking burn everything.
Yes.
Can you just imagine living in the beach and just like constantly spamming the fucking fire spell to practice it? Thanks, Veronica. You're one of the good ones. Hope you never die.
Honestly, I thought to practice the fire spell, but I know they're the best spot. You know what? The cornfield is probably the best spot to practice my fire spells.
You also have like wet versions of the seeds. They're still as weak as ever, so fuck. So don't be afraid of them.
And now I'm wanted in 6 other nations.
Man, you looked at Lollyhentai one time, and now you are wanted in 6 other nations. Can you believe that?
Man, let's be a rough life.
If you look at those 6 nations, you all notice that they have really dumb laws anyway. I like how Amazon is like banning every single anime figure in existence for apparently because it's like, it seems like CP, but it's like Big Titty Onason.
Well, no, you see, it's not. It looks like CP because it's gonna be all the young boys are gonna buy it, and we can't have that. Honestly, I don't think anything will make sense, no matter how much you try to joke about it.
My God. I don't really like Amazon taking a moral stance, considering someone died in their workplace and everyone just kept working because they're too busy.
Yeah.
It's like, what the fuck?
I think you have heard the news, right? About
apparently it's pretty normal to piss in a bottle, too. In Amazon.
Oh, it's like, you know, I thought we were better than having spread shops, but then again, it's like when you're rich, you get away with
this. The funny part is, everyone can leave whenever they want to, but they don't. But my favorite part, my favorite suggestion of Amazon is like, we should put workers in cages.
Well, you see, Jess, they cannot leave because they're wage slaves. You know, see, they have to work, otherwise they cannot find work at other places.
Well, you can keep being a wage slave forever then.
Yeah.
If everyone of Amazon were to leave Amazon, Amazon would go would get fucked.
Honestly,
that's the same thing for every nation. It's just we have to do it collectively. We don't do that shit.
It's like, fuck unions, they're fucking useless. You just have to fucking make everybody work at once. Just quit or just stop working. And when it stops working, they can't do anything. It's just you have to find a motivation for everybody to just stand still and do nothing.
Right. You can also just go out and just start your own company together.
Yeah. But unions don't seem to be working out at all.
Because, and it's better to have a union than not one union, but it's not really the answer to the problem.
Yes. And then the next fucking second, when you try to start a union, they start pulling up all of these fucking progressive nonsense to end unions.
Yeah.
who would have thought? The most progressive thing in the world, you need to stop by the progressive fucking...
Progressivism became because it is an easy tool to deflect criticism on the fucking big corporations.
Yeah.
So I don't stop the Wall Street protests.
Yeah, just say a few things and the people will go back home.
Basically.
Words, I love it. It's like, it's such... idiots, only idiots just keep listening to words and never look at your actions.
Basically.
Well, I love the fucking field. Looks beautiful. Looks so realistic. I think you can climb up these fucking... No, it's just this one that you can go up on. The windmill. Mush mush?
Yeah, I'm still here.
Sorry,
my brain is working right now. It's like... It's like, I have to think about how hungry I am. I have to think about what was I doing again. I was playing, I was like doing a comment. Alright. Reboot. That's some gold ore.
Oh, it's gonna be so much fun just looking for all these fucking ores.
Honestly, from my memory, it feels like gold ore is the most useless. I don't know, I don't feel like I've made a lot of things with gold ore.
Are you sure you're not talking about Minecraft?
There's a Dragon Quest Minecraft.
Oh, right.
Never played Builders though. Should I just skip Builders 1 and just play Builders 2 if I had to start wanting to play Builders?
I wouldn't know.
Yeah, you're right. Maybe chat knows. Welcome to the Warriors Fest, where wanderers from all over Adria stop, share, tell, or to have to take a break from their travels. It's a long break from us, that's all. I was getting all smart to rest, blah blah blah. Fun fact, zwaard is Dutch for sword, and rust is Dutch for west. I'm just saying. I can't really think of what other nation this place would represent, though, if it isn't that, so... That's why I was thinking, it's like, is this my nation? Is this me? Am I being represented in video game? No, your nation is dead.
Well, it is. If you want to be more represented, maybe you should like go into Street Fight and see if there's a Dutch representative character.
That's actually a good point. I don't think there is one.
Because I know Turks and the Moroccans got theirs. I think the obvious one. The other.
What do you mean? We already have Germans in the game. Fuck you. This character.
So what is it with fairy tale? Mm-hmm. And having all of these female characters posing in swimsuits?
Okay, let me explain that one. I actually don't know how to explain this one. So there was this tournament, and they had like a tag team battle or something. But one of the female characters decided to do her special technique is seduction. But there's another female character that she's fighting against, and she tried to seduce back. And then someone, for some reason, all the other people characters decided to jump down and have a beauty contest instead.
Oh, that sounds fun.
So, apparently this guy, he is born in the Netherlands, this guy right here. Doesn't really look like a stereotype, does he? Like, what the fuck is he supposed to represent?
What the hell is he supposed to represent? Yeah, he's fucking, I guess, tall, but everybody's tall as Street Fighter. What a disappointment.
I'm disappointed. Where is representation? Where is my autistic Dutch, like, gamer? Where is my representation?
Where is the weed? Why is this spoken weed?
Where is the weed?
Well, at least the fucking Turks got a fat ass that uses oil fighting. No joke. I think his name was Hassan as well.
I could Ja, Hakan.
Hakan.
Birthplace Turkey.
Yes.
Likes his wife, his daughter. Chianko Nabe, traditional Japanese stew. Just like cigarettes, fire, industrial espionage, CIN, for building weapons, others claiming that their style is superior to his. Hey, this is like salt, please.
Probably lost bread.
Turkish I think oil wrestler. Devoted family man.
Wait, what? Of course.
He's a devoted family man. And...
Of course. Then again, I think everybody is devoted family fan in this fucking game.
It's the easiest way to like make people likable, Ennis.
Yeah. There's like, remember the golden line from fucking Gal. It's like, go back to your family and become a family man.
So
he said that to Chun-Li, by the way.
My favorite thing in like, I was playing Guilty Gear. And I was playing one character, and you have this other character who's fighting with like an anchor, right? Mm-hmm. I beat her with ease, and then my character at the end of the fight basically said, "Who was she anyway? What was she even doing here?" As if she was fucking useless. Anyway, here we've got a treasure chest. We found another mini battle. And we have to jump on this vein to get to the other side of the place to get that like thing. To get the sparkly spot. The closest town is many miles away. Is it now? I guess we're gonna end the recording session here. And then we'll be back with more Dragon Quest. We're not... Yeah, I guess I'll just end... I guess I ended the part where I end the recording session. Because why not? Oh, 31 minutes long.